This is Nick.
And this is Anne.
They're astronauts who have spent time on the International Space Station.
And you all did some spacewalking, correct?
We did.
We've got some tools here that you would use on a spacewalk. Do you want to tell us what these tools are and how you use them?
Sure. This first one is a safety tether. And this is one of our most important, if not the most important tool that we learn how to use on a spacewalk. This is what keeps us attached to the space station at all times. So no matter if we let go or if we're translating, if we're going anywhere on the station, station's about the size of a football field and each one of these tethers can reach about 85 feet. So there's two hooks. We have a, here we go. This is a load alleviating strap, we call it. And so if I pull really hard against the safety tether, that'll actually give a little bit. And then this piece is a reel, and this acts just like a retractable dog leash does. And so no matter how far we go on station, it keeps pulling and pulling and pulling, and this is a nice, strong, braided cable, which keeps us safe. So we, if you listen to a spacewalk, you'll hear us talking about tethers a lot. We're always aware of where these are, where they're anchored, and where our cables are.
And Nick, what are these little copper things?
Yeah, so these little copper things are wires. We call them wire ties. Anne and I both had the good fortune of doing an EVA where we spent a lot of time installing these on the outside of the station. So when we put new equipment outside, it's all connected with power and data, and those cables have to go somewhere. And so rather than letting them float around in space, we take these wire ties and we hook them around a handrail and twist them closed with the cables underneath, and keeps everything nice and close to the station. And so it seems like a very simple thing to do, but if you can imagine being outside in a pressurized suit, putting these wire ties on for 6 hours, it doesn't take very long before your hands are exhausted.
Awesome. Now there's one other piece of equipment that y'all didn't mention that's used on a spacewalk. We've got a little bit of science and a little bit of magic that we're going to try to learn about that. So if you all can take the water and pour it into one of the cups.
We'll pick the middle one.
All right. Now we're going to shuffle the cups.
Okay. All right. Want to do the shuffling?
Yep.
Shuffle them up. Okay. If you're watching, follow the one with the water in it. See if you can pick out which one it is. All right, which one do you think has the water in it? All right, which one?
Well, what?
I lost track.
Let's see, does that one have the water? Not that one. If you guessed that one, you were wrong. How about the one over there?
That one.
Oh, no water in that one.
Woo!
All right, how about the middle one?
All right, well, let's see. How did that go? Oh, like that.
Oh, where did the water go?
Wait a minute.
We did put a little something into the cup before we started.
And this science goes back to a really important piece of equipment that you all need when you're on a spacewalk.
Y'all want to tell us about this?
Sure. It actually is a really important piece of equipment. So I mentioned we do a 6 hour spacewalk or 7 hour spacewalk, but you're actually in the spacesuit for almost 12 hours. And so if you can imagine, you might have to go to the bathroom.
Yep.
And so this is our MAG, our maximum absorbency garment, or as everybody else would call it, a diaper.
Yeah, so the next time you're watching a spacewalk, think about all the equipment that we're using that you can see and the equipment that you can't see.